10 things we learned from this routing charts. The first one was windrows, the second one was ocean currents, the third one was ice limits. Hello Navigator, in this video we are going to talk about Admiralty routing charts. What are the informations we get from this Admiralty routing charts? We'll try to figure it out by practically observing the charts itself. So here you can see on the display our topic is highlighted with yellow. The first one attachment you can see here is the original Admiralty routing charts for the Indian Ocean, and you know this routing charts is particularly for each month. So this one is for the month of August, and the next one we see, this is the scale of the charts, and the next we cannot see it, read it properly from here, so we'll go down and we'll try to read out only this part. Okay, routing charts, this is the scale, at which scale this chart has been produced, and what type of chart, this is Mercator chart. The content is basically starts from down below. This is the one first content, and this is wind rose, this one on the chart. And by observing this wind rose, we understand the intensity of the wind, that means the force of the wind, and the direction, most probable direction and most probable force of the wind that a sailor can expect or a navigator can expect in particular position. That is why there are so many, because this is for this particular position. So in separate video I will show you how to get the information properly from a wind rose. Hope that will be helpful for you, but for the time being, just to inform you that there is a scale, this scale to be used, and this is the Beaufort projection on the wind rose. Each wind rose is marked with this type of projection, like this one. Hope the separate video will cover each and every details of this wind rose. So now we, for the timing, we will just record what are the informations we are getting. Wind rose, and you know better to write actually what we get from this wind rose. Number one, we get the wind direction. Number two, force, and this is of course probable. The whole charts is probable, nothing is fixed. The next one we see is ocean currents. Okay, so ocean currents are basically the water flow of the sea. You'll see this is the ocean current mark, like from which side to which side this water is flowing in this month, in the month of August. And of course you will get a idea of you know, the consistency, or you can say the probability, and the rate as well. This is like, if it is written half, then it you may expect half knot. Like here it is also mentioned, this is the one half. Okay, some are one, like this one, one. Okay, like this. Anyway, let's record it. The second one we come to know about ocean currents. And ocean currents, basically what is this? This is the water flow at sea. Then the next one, that is ice. You can say ice limit and other specific ice information. Like below I have kept a record of this chart. You see, this is the Indian Ocean, the same chart, and there is a iceberg information. The breaking away of ice from Antarctic continent takes place on a large scale. Huge numbers of icebergs are found within the southern area of this chart. Mariners are advised to navigate with particular caution. This one indicates a particular ice information for this chart. Here we will write, for our note we will write number 3, we will come to know about ice limits or ice information. Okay, we can write here ice, and then what basically what kind of ice information we get. We get ice limits and cautionary messages. Next one, we will try to find out what kind of information we get from this Admiralty routing charts, that is a load line. In this routing charts, we will also find the load line marks like this one. You can see this is the load line separation for tropical and summer zone divaridation, you can see. And the load line convention is produced for the safety of the ship. We'll keep a note here, load line limits, okay, or you can say zones. So what is the load line zones? Basically, read from here, limit of load line zones. For further information, Admiralty charts D6083, this is a load line charts. I'll show you what is this load line charts. It is separate chart having the details of load lines only. The world load line regulations, this is D6083, this is load line charts, and I will try to cover this load line in separate video. But for your information, again, let's make it shortcut here. We'll come to know about the load line limits. Limit of load line. Then the fifth one, what we get from this Admiralty routing charts is shipping routes. Okay, as you can see, there are marking of routes. Like this is the routes. Okay, like this, these are the routes. These are kind of, you can say, recommended route for this month. And this recommendation, how they have produced? They have produced the routes shown are the most frequently used routes derived from AIS data. According to this information, you can see routes can be ram line, great circle, or composite great circle. And so first of all, we come to know that route can be great circle route or composite great circle or ram line. Anyway, distances, that means length of the route, are shown in nautical miles. Okay, so it is in nautical miles. All the distances, you can see distances are also mentioned here for a particular route, like here, check this one, this one, or this one from Hong Kong to Manila. This is the distance, 630 nautical mile, like this. Okay, let's read further. It says these routes are provided as a guide only. Okay, for further information, see Admiralty Ocean Passes for the World NP136 and the Mariner's Handbook NP100 and Admiralty Distances Table. So these guides are also recommended by this Admiralty routing charts. But here you see the routine show, the routes shown are most frequently used routes derived from AIS data. That means they monitored the AIS data for all the vessels trading in these areas, and they produced the most used routes. So again, this is not something very fixed. You can just say that this is a guide only. So anyway, we can keep the note that we will get the ship's route. Okay, here we can write recommended route for this month. Next one, we'll see what we get from this wind force 7 and above. So this we'll see in separate picture, it will be better for us. So it says about frequency of wind force 7 and above. Selected tropical storm tracks since 1990. You can see a red marking over this corner. and these are the tropical storms tracks since 1990 till the date and when this chart has been produced. And this part is further, it says about frequency of wind force 7 and above. Euphoric scale 7 means already it's a gale wind. So for the understanding of Euphoric scale, I'll make separate video for this. I hope you will come to know what are the Euphoric scales and the details. So for the time being, we can write the information as TRS routes, tropical revolving storm routes. So TRS data, okay, tropical revolving storm. Okay, then the next one we see the information available here is mean sea surface temperature. That means for this whole area, the same coverage with the chart, we can get the idea of sea surface, mean sea surface temperature, the blue one, okay, and the red one is mean dew point temperature. So we'll come to know about the dew point temperature as well. Let's keep the record mean sea surface temperature and mean dew point temperature. Sea surface temperature, mean dew point temperature. So far we have come to know about the 7 points. For others, I will write further below, like number 8, number 9, we can write from here. Now next one is air temperature. So that means we will get the idea of air temperature as well, and mean sea level pressure. Mean sea level pressure is red one and the mean air temperature is blue one. Okay, air temperature and sea surface pressure, huh? Let me tell you, this full area is expected as 1012 millibar pressure, okay, sea surface pressure. Likewise, you have to read this way, like for this one, for 1016, this is 1016, this is for whole this area. And same for the temperature as well, like this one, if it is says 20 here, that means for all this area, blue marking, okay, that means same for following the line, same temperature and same pressure. Okay, so the next one, low visibility frequency of visibility and fog, probability of fog. So I will write here as a note, visibility, and we can write only visibility. I hope this will be perfectly okay. Okay, we'll get an idea about the visibility as well from this Admiralty routing charts. This is the one remaining. I'll talk about this now. As you can see, there is the limits of routing charts, and there are many others. There are many other routing charts as well covering other parts of the world. Like the one we were checking is 5126 Indian Ocean, covering this part. But there are many others as well, like for the North Atlantic, for Mediterranean Sea, and for North Pacific Ocean. For even there are few more within the charts that we were covering. You see, this is Bay of Bengal separately, there is available, and for Arabian Sea and Red Sea, there is separately available. So these are the other routing charts, and for your information, all of these routing charts are available for each month. That means from January to December, there are 12 charts for each of this area, routing charts. And does it mean that every year you have to bring new? No, it doesn't change much. Once the previous chart is cancelled, only in that case you can order for the new one. Otherwise, for your trading area, you will probably see very rare there is any changes. So that's it. We will find the number 10, we can write other routine charts limit and name. So this 10 parts I think is sufficient enough. These 10 things we learned from this routing charts. The first one was windrows, the second one was ocean currents, the third one was ice limits, or you can say ice information. The fourth one was load line limits. Fifth one was ship's route. Then the sixth one was TRS data, that is tropical revolving storm data. Then the seventh one was sea surface temperature and mean dew point temperature. The eighth one was air temperature and sea surface pressure. Ninth one was visibility, and the 10th one was other routing charts limit and name of those routing charts.